Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi is dead.
President Donald Trump announcing the founder and leader of ISIS has died on Trump's orders and at the hands of U.S. Special Forces. Speaking to the nation from the White House, Trump described the raid carried out by American troops in northwestern Syria that killed perhaps the world's most wanted man, Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. American intelligence tracked down his hideout near the Turkish border, commandos storming the compound on Saturday night and chasing al-Baghdadi into a dead-end tunnel, where the president says the top terrorist leader spent his final moments
whimpering and crying and screaming all the way.
He apparently detonated a suicide vest, blowing himself up as American military dogs were closing in, the blast also killing three of his children.
He died like a dog. He died like a coward. He
will never again. The news began to break overnight when Trump tweeted, "Something very big has just happened." And something very big did happen. The killing of al-Baghdadi is a major foreign policy win for Trump at a time when even members of his own party have slammed him for withdrawing American troops from northern Syria, fearing it would create a terrorist breeding ground there. Trump, who watched the action surrounded by top advisors in the Situation Room, seemed to suggest al-Baghdadi's death is a bigger deal than the Obama administration's takedown of Osama bin Laden. During al-Baghdadi's reign, ISIS conquered and imposed its brutal rule on huge parts of Iraq and Syria, executing anyone who stood in the way of their leader. Senator Lindsey Graham, who was one of the most outspoken critics on Trump's Syria decision, praised the operation.
This is a moment where President Trump's worst critic should say, "Well done, Mr. President."
So how are Democrats responding to all this? House Speaker Nancy Pelosi applauding what has happened, but saying that Trump notified the Russians before congressional leaders. She's now calling on the president to brief lawmakers on the raid, which killed the ISIS leader. Symbolically, that's a blow for the group. But terror cells with links to ISIS continue to exist around the world. Pelosi saying, yes, his death is significant, but it doesn't end the threat.